the past 6 months, this AI agent has joined every single one of our calls. Now it's completely changed the way my team and I approach our meetings. But perhaps the craziest part is we set this agent up without writing a single line of code. But more on that later. First, let me show you how it works. Our AI agent automatically joins all of our meetings on our calendar 1 minute before they start. So that way it's waiting for us. Whenever we join a meeting, we just need to let the agent in. And when it joins, it drops a little message into the chat, letting people know that it's here to record and transcribe the meeting so that we can focus on having a meaningful conversation. So after the call is done, our agent is going to send a summary directly to us via Slack, which will cover the key points of what was discussed in the meeting, as well as split any action items per person of what needs to be done. We can also just in one click directly access the meeting recording, the full transcript, or a condensed summary of the meeting notes. And I probably know what you're thinking, that right now this isn't very impressive at all, and this is like any other meeting note taker tool on the market, but this is where it gets interesting. What I can do directly in Slack, I can reply to this summary that the agent sent and have a conversation with my agent about what took place in the meeting. So I could ask a follow-up question like, was pricing mentioned during the discussion? And this agent, because it has full memory of what happened in the meeting, every word that was said, it's now going to access that memory and answer my question based on what was discussed in the call. And after a few seconds, our agent has replied, yes, though the exact amount wasn't mentioned, the discussion included the early stage pack with a 20% discount. Now we can actually take this further and turn like just asking questions, but rather turn it into action. So this is never anything I would directly write in an email. It's just my quick thoughts of what I want the agent to prepare. And it has full context of the meeting and it's going to use that in drafting the email. And again, a few seconds later, our agent has replied with the email subject and the body. Hi, Alice, thanks for your discussion. My colleague Piv will be sending a payment link with the 20% discount we discussed. Could you please confirm the start date? And here it remembers the date that was discussed in the meeting. This is not something I gave it here in the prompt. And also please send over the list of 5 team members. Here I just said the list of students, and in it had context of the meeting that we agreed on 5 team members taking part in the training. Now, the fact that this is an AI agent means here we're only just scratching the surface, and we can customize this even further. And in a minute, I'm going to show you exactly how to set this up for yourself using Lindy.ai. But for example, the fact that here right now it's drafting an email in Slack, we could also connect our agent to our Gmail so that I can instruct it to directly draft the email or even send the email via our Gmail account. We could integrate our agent with our task management system, whether that's Notion, Asana, or ClickUp, and it could already create tasks for the different action items it has understood, and it can integrate with pretty much any other tool in your stack. So here's what this agent has done for our team and what it can do for yours. First, it's transformed how we actually participate in our meetings. Everyone's able to be fully engaged and participate in the conversation, and no one's distracted frantically taking notes or updating systems on the side. We can focus completely on discussing ideas and making decisions with full confidence that our AI agent is capturing all the important information. Now, secondly, the time savings when following up on past discussions is incredible. It happens so often that maybe 3 weeks ago, we were discussing with a company about a potential workshop, and in the call, we discussed all the key objectives they had. Then over the next 2 weeks, we had back and forth via email trying to find a date for the workshop. And then finally, when that was agreed, we now need to actually start preparing. Now, rather than needing to have another call and going over these points again or re-watching the recordings, we know we can just ask our agent any questions we have about what was discussed, and we're going to get instant answers. Thirdly, and this is probably the biggest one for us, it has drastically reduced the number of meetings myself and my 2 co-founders need to attend. Previously, we were always showing up, the 3 of us, to customer meetings just so that we can stay in the loop. Now, most of the times, only one of us needs to be there, and the others can stay in the loop by either reading the summary, we can tag them directly in Slack when there's something important they should check out, and they, of course, can ask their own questions directly to the agent about what was discussed, and if needed, they can check out those parts of the recording. This alone has given each of us back about 10 hours every week. Now, we've tested many other meeting tools, but for us, the key difference in this setup is that we can actually have a conversation with our meeting history. It's like having an employee who was present for every discussion you have ever had and remembers it 24/7. Now let's take a look under the hood. We built this agent using Lindy.ai, and I want to quickly walk you through the setup so that you can implement this for yourself. This is our agent set up in Lindy. At the end of the video, I'm going to show you how you can easily just copy this template and import it yourself, configure a couple of things, and then you're right to get started. But now I just want to walk you through the setup so that you can understand what's happening. Especially if you're new to AI agents, it's going to be good to get a breakdown of this step by step. So in Lindy, we have this flow editor where we can determine the actions of our agents, how it should behave in certain situations. And also in the settings, we can give it some additional context. So in the context, you're giving like the high level goal or task that the agent should achieve. So in the flow editor, let's take a look. First, you'll notice that there's two triggers for my agent. First of all, there's the calendar event started. And so here, all I need to do is connect my Google Calendar. And here's what I mentioned, that it joins 1 minute before the meeting starts. So this is whenever you have an event in your calendar, 1 minute before it will try and join. Now, the first thing we have is a conditional logic, which says only continue if the event contains a meeting link. Because sometimes, for instance, if you're using your calendar, like your task management system, and you're putting in time blockers, if there's not a specific meeting link, then the agent shouldn't try and move on and record the meeting. Now you might be asking, why do we have another trigger here? And this is triggered by a Lindy message. So in Lindy, every agent, when it runs, creates what are known as tasks. And if we have a look here in the task view, what I can simply do is send a message to my agent. And the reason why we have that trigger is sometimes you may get pulled in to an ad hoc meeting that isn't in your calendar. And if you want to bring your agent in, all I need to do here is paste either the Google Calendar, the Teams, or the Zoom link, and then the agent will join the call. Now, going back down the flow, so obviously if we've identified that there is an event with a meeting link, we tell our agent to record the meeting. And this is a specific action created by Lindy. And you'll notice here that it joins, records, and transcribes Google Meet, Zoom, or Microsoft Teams meetings. So it doesn't matter which tool you're using for your calls, or if you're using more than one, this agent is able to join it. After that, what happens is you'll get from this a transcript as well as the video recording. And notice here that it says the URLs are valid for just 24 hours after the meeting. So it suggests uploading the video to Google Drive. And that's exactly what we do in the next step. We just tell our agent to upload to Google Drive. Again, I'm connected with my Google account. And here what's very interesting about Lindy and these AI agent building platforms is whenever we upload a video here, we have to give it a file name and a file URL. But what I've done is in Lindy, whenever you need to fill out a field, you can either set a value manually, you can put in a prompt and instruct the agent how it should fill out this field, or you can just leave it as auto. And based on the context of this current task, it will know what information it needs to put in here. So for instance, it's getting a URL of a video from the record meeting step, and it's automatically able to determine that that should be the URL that it uploads to Google Drive. Now, I'll touch on this task URL in a second. Now, next up, we're creating a Google Doc. And the reason we're creating a Google document, again, I'm connected with my account, is simply to save the transcript. So we have the transcript of the meeting. And this time you'll notice that I'm actually setting this manually, and I've basically mapped this to the outcome of the record meeting step. And I've just dropped in there the transcript. The title, I'm letting the AI decide what is the best title for that document. Next up, what I do, and this is the step where we're actually creating our meeting summary and sending those messages. And I'm basically sending that in two places. First of all, I'm sending it back to the Lindy chat. Now, the reason why we also send the message back to Lindy is because, look, if we look now at the task view, so here on the left-hand side, we have for each meeting that the agent joined, it creates a new task or a new session. And also when we're in this view, we also want to have access to the high-level summary and meeting notes. Next up, we also send the message to the Slack channel. And here you can see I've connected my Slack and told it exactly which channel it should send the summary to. But now for the message, and it's actually the same for the message that we set to Lindy, I'm not telling it exactly how it should send the meeting, but rather I'm giving it a prompt. And here I'm saying, using the meeting transcript, craft highly accurate meeting notes. And now in my prompt, I stipulate exactly how the summary should be structured, so that it should first have an overview split into a couple of parts, and then should have action items. And then I'm also telling it to hyperlink, for instance, the Lindy conversation, and that's what we're getting from this get task URL. Also, I'm telling it to hyperlink the Google Drive of the recording and also the full transcript. And here I can say, if there's any 9x email users that were in the meeting, feel free to tag them using their email address. And this is a specific thing of Slack, so that then whoever is in the meeting will basically get tagged in the summary. Now, after this, what you'll notice is whenever we have this send a message action, whether this is a Lindy message or a Slack message, we always get two options. We get after the message is sent, continue and do something else. So for instance, after I send the Lindy message, I want to send the Slack message. But then there's also another option from both of these points, which is after a reply is received. And this is a particular action that Lindy gives us whenever we send a message. So that could be when you send an email, Slack message, Teams message, using a Lindy message. We can trigger something else if someone replies to that message. And this is where our AI agent kicks in. So all we have now is if you ever get a reply either to a Lindy message or the Slack message, our agent will kick in and all we have to do is give it a simple prompt. So here I'm saying answer to follow up questions from the user in the channel the question came from. So in the case of Slack, send the message back to Slack. In the case of someone asking in the Lindy task view, send the answer back to the Lindy task view. And now, what's very interesting with agents compared to typical automations is all you need to do is give them a prompt and then give it certain skills. So here I've given it some skills to be able to observe Slack messages and to be able to send Slack messages in that Slack thread. And the same as observe messages that come in the Lindy chat and also send messages in the Lindy chat. So just by doing this, and when I prompted it to draft an email, it was successfully able to kick in, have the AI agent draft an email, and it has full context of what happened before. So the meeting transcript, all the items in the Google Doc, the messages that were sent before, it has all of that in its memory whenever it is answering the questions in this agent step. Now, this is where I said you can take this further. So all I need to do is give our agent access to more skills. So for instance, here I could add Gmail and give it the ability to draft an email in my Gmail account, or also even directly send an email. Now, whenever you add skills, what you typically want to do is improve this prompt here. So I could say something like, only use the Gmail send Gmail action when you get confirmation on Slack, or only draft an email when you are instructed to on Slack. And the same thing is here, we can access any of the other integrations that Lindy have created for us. For instance, if we want to create a contact in HubSpot, we could connect it and let our agent do that. As I said, creating tasks in Notion, the list goes on. This is super, super powerful. Now, as promised, I did say if you want to implement this for yourself, in the description below, you will find a link to a tutorial on our website. Here you'll have the full template that you can just in one click import into your Lindy account. And in the tutorial, we'll give you step-by-step instructions on how you can configure these different steps. Now, if you found this video helpful in any way, please give it a like. Also, click on the screen right now to subscribe to the 9X channel or to check out some of our other videos. Until next time, happy automating.